Unemployment is pretty simple to explain. Unemployment basically follows national income. Hence, if interest rate goes up, AD goes down, national income goes down even more due to a multiplier effect, then unemployment will go up because less people will be required to for production in the economy. Similarly, if interest rate goes down, AD goes up, national income goes up even more due to the multiplier effect, then unemployment decreases because more people will be required for production in the economy. However, is it that simple? Well, this is a rather superficial analysis that most people tend to make. We can dig deeper in two areas, one being the type of unemployment that monetary policy affects, and the other being the position of the AD on the AS. The only type of unemployment that monetary policy dictates is cyclical unemployment. It does nothing to facilitate the flow of information and help other people transit between jobs. Hence, it does not do anything to frictional unemployment. Neither does it help people gain new skills. It does not do anything to structural unemployment here. However, it does affect demand-driven unemployment, your cyclical unemployment, because it helps to push our economy towards full employment. Now, you do remember that full employment means zero cyclical unemployment, but not zero frictional, nor structural unemployment, right? Good. So it only affects cyclical unemployment. Second, the effects on employment depend entirely on the position of the AD on the AS. So let's say that the AD is in the Keynesian region, hence there are lots of unemployed people in the market and there's lots of spare capacity in the economy. Then when you decrease the interest rate and exercise expansionary monetary policy, you can decrease cyclical unemployment because that is cyclical unemployment in the first place. However, if you're already producing at the full capacity of the economy and everyone is already employed, how can you still employ more people? Hence, the effects of the expansionary monetary policy, if the central bank is stupid enough to do that at a time of full production, will be purely inflationary.